Defiance has five categories of weapons and also shields. Starting from white, which is the most basic and the most common item that you're going to loot off the ground or from battles and so forth. So white weapons have a brief description up the top of what the weapon is, the category that it falls under, and I'll cover that a little later. Also, it's as status is in terms of mastery as well, and again, I'll cover that too. So we'll come back to that. Down the bottom, you'll see the stats here, the base damage it will inflict, its fire rate. The higher that number, the faster the rounds are going to come pumping out, how much you can carry in the magazine. You've got a reload rate as well. The lower that number, the faster you're going to be able to reload that weapon too. Your critical multiplier, the weapon applies critical damage, what the multiplier of that damage is going to be, so that'll carry an additional 0.6 on top of every hit that's critical. And the bloom, this is the deviation of bullets, the prey and spray radius, I suppose. The higher that number, the less likely a bullet is to hit the crosshair when you pull the trigger. It will have a much wider spread. The lower the number, right down to zero, is how likely it is to hit your target reticle. This is from a purely stationary position, so if you're moving around, you're going to get a level of deviation as well, and that can be modified by using mods and so forth, which I'll cover at a later time. White weapons also carry one additional bonus attached to that weapon too. This is a base ability, so this has got an extra 0.5% of magazine there. That's instead of 40, it's 42. It's just got an extra two bullets loaded in there. Now going to the green category, you'll see it's practically identical, other than this has got an additional ability or bonus attached to it. It's got a slightly higher critical multiplier, so you'll see that crit rate go up, and you can already see that reflected down the bottom there. Other than that, these two are pretty much identical. It's not uncommon to find a white weapon that's doing higher damage than a green, or a green weapon that's even doing higher damage than a purple weapon from a base multiplier point of view. So from what I can see, the stats look completely random. But these bonuses, the combination of bonuses, obviously can make a big difference. So depending on the weapon, you may look for bonuses that are going to give you more from when you look at the individual factors, such as the fire rate or the amount of base damage that it's inflicting, or how it reloads, or whatever the case may be. So you know, you can make a judgment from there. Your next tier up are the blue weapons, which again are all more or less identical, other than they carry a third bonus on there as well. Purples carry a fourth, so here you go, there's a fourth ability attached to that one, right down to the orange weapons, which carry the fifth, and these are the highest tier weapons in the game that I'm aware of. There's also named weapons as well. I'm not sure, this precise chaos just doesn't seem to have the same name as everything else, so I'm guessing this one is a named weapon, but it's blue tier, so you can draw your conclusions from that. You'll notice that particular weapons, like exotic weapons or explosive based weapons, will also carry additional information on there. This has got a minimum to maximum damage range, a blast radius factor in there too, so looking at each individual weapon will give you the information that you're looking for to, you know, make choices about what you how it's going to suit your particular playstyle or whatever the case may be.